A very good morning, friends. Today's topic of discussion is recombinant DNA technology or genetic engineering. The other words are gene cloning, gene manipulation. You may get a long answer question in university examination on this topic. This is a very, very important topic and frequently asked question in university examination. We'll discuss this topic with respect to definition, steps, tools in recombinant DNA technology, and their applications. We'll discuss this topic in short as to cover the LAQ in university examination. Now coming to the definition, in this recombinant DNA technology, it involves manipulation of genetic material, that is DNA, to achieve a desired goal in a predetermined way. So this is a gene manipulation technique in which manipulation is done to achieve a desired goal in a predetermined way. Now coming to the steps involved in recombinant DNA technology, there are six main steps they are involved in the recombinant DNA technology. The first one is isolation of desired DNA, desired piece of DNA. Second important step is isolation of vector. Then third step is production of hybrid DNA, recombinant DNA or chimeric DNA production. Then fourth, introduction into a host cell. Fifth, multiplication and selection of cell with recombinant DNA molecule. And sixth one is the expression of gene to produce desired product. So these are the six important steps in recombinant DNA technology. The first one is isolation of DNA, isolation of vector, production of chimeric DNA or recombinant DNA or hybrid DNA molecule, introduction of this chimeric DNA into a host cell, multiplication and selection of cells with recombinant DNA, and expression of gene to produce a desired product. Now coming to the one by one, the first step in genetic engineering is isolation of desired piece of DNA. First, isolation of desired piece of DNA. So this is a donor DNA molecule and this is a desired piece of DNA which is shown in red. Now for that, it is surrounded by the cell wall. For the isolation of DNA molecule, treat the cell with enzyme and detergent. After that, treat it with phenol, proteases and ribonuclease. Then ultracentrifugation is done and DNA is obtained by treatment with chilled ethanol, you will get DNA molecule after treatment with chilled ethanol. Now this DNA molecule, it is acted upon by the restriction endonuclease, which is a DNA cutting enzyme, and converts this DNA into multiple pieces of DNA molecule, which gets separated by electrophoresis and identified by sudden blotting technique. Sudden blotting technique. In this way, you will get a desired piece of DNA. So this is the first step, isolation of desired piece of DNA and treatment with restriction endonuclease. So this is the first step, DNA molecule treated with restriction endonuclease, which is a DNA cutting enzyme. After the treatment with restriction endonuclease, you will get a desired piece of DNA with sticky end. Sticky end means it is a single stranded DNA molecule which get attached with the another single stranded DNA molecule. So this is a sticky DNA molecule after the treatment with restriction endonuclease. Now second step is the isolation of vector. Second step is isolation of vector. Generally prokaryotic vectors are selected because of rapid multiplication. So the vector, suppose this is a plasmid, which is a vector in the recombinant DNA technology. It is surrounded by the bacterial cell wall, bacterial wall. The bacterial cell is treated with enzyme EDTA and lysozymes. Then it is treated with sodium lauryl sarcosinate to get a plasmid, which is separated by either ultracentrifugation or electrophoresis. So you will get a plasmid. So this is a second step, isolation of vector. Then treat the vector with same restriction endonuclease. Then you will get a sticky end, the plasmid with sticky end. Now third step is the hybridization or production of chimeric DNA. So this is the first step, isolation of desired piece of DNA followed by isolation of vector treated with restriction endonuclease, and you will get a plasmid with sticky end which is ready to attach with this desired piece of gene. Now third step is formation of chimeric DNA. This chimera, this word, it is from mythology. In mythology, chimera means the hybrid substance or hybrid compound. For example, it is described with the Narsimha. Narsimha, it has lion's head and serpent tail. So it is a hybrid molecule or hybrid person. So chimera meaning is hybrid DNA molecule or recombinant DNA molecule, which is produced with the help of desired piece of gene and plasmid treated with restriction endonuclease. So this is the third step in recombinant DNA technology. So third step, it is formation of chimeric DNA. For this formation or ligation, the enzyme is required, that is DNA ligase. This is known as DNA joining enzyme and it requires ATP. There is formation of phosphodiesterase linkage. So this is a desired piece of gene and this is a plasmid molecule. Now fourth step is introduction into a host cell. Introduction into host cell. So it is now introduced into a host cell with the help of various gene transfer methods. So this is plasmid. It is a recombinant DNA, desired piece of gene, and this is a bacterial genetic material. Introduction into a host cell. This is the fourth step. Then fifth is the multiplication in the host cell and selection of cells that contain chimeric DNA. This is the fifth step, which is done by the hybridization technique with the help of probes or by using the antibiotic resistance. These are the two techniques by which the selection of cells containing chimeric DNA is done. After that, sixth important step is expression of gene to produce desired product. So this cell is converted into two cells are converted into 4 into 8 into 16 and so on. After that, this desired piece of gene will produce a desired protein on transcription and translation process. So these are the steps involved in recombinant DNA technology. Now we'll study the various tools which are useful in the recombinant DNA technology. The first is the enzymes. The molecular tools in recombinant DNA technology, first is the enzymes. The various exonucleases and endonucleases, they are useful in the recombinant DNA technology. Exonuclease cut the outer nucleotides, while endonuclease act on internal phosphodiester linkage. The important one is the restriction endonuclease. There are three types of restriction endonuclease, 1, 2 and 3. Of these, 1 and 3 requires ATP, and 1 and 3 cut the DNA molecule away from the recognition sequence. The restriction endonuclease 2 is important for us because it cuts the DNA molecule within a recognition sequence. Recognition sequence is a sequence of 4 to 6 nucleotides and it is palindromic, which read similarly in either direction. For example, G A A T T C. This is one single strand and this is the other strand, G A A T T C. So this is read similarly in both directions. The simple word is madam. Madam. It is a palindromic sequence which read in both directions. It is madam from this direction also and this direction also. It is known as palindromic DNA sequence. It is known as recognition sequence. Restriction endonuclease act on recognition sequence, which is 4 to 6 base pair in length. For example, this restriction endonuclease E. coli R1. This is a restriction endonuclease. The name, they are named according to the bacteria from which they are isolated. The first letter indicates the genus. Second, it indicates the species, then strain, and the order of discovery, or the individual number which is given by the discoverer. So, E. coli RY13 is the strain, and one Roman one is a first in a order of discovery. So, E. coli RY13-1 is a restriction endonuclease. They are isolated from E. coli. They are restricting the growth of viruses in the E. coli. That's why the name is given restriction endonuclease. They act on this sequence, this site, on both DNA strand, and you will get this G, then A, T, C, and here you will get C, T, A, and G, like that. So you will get a sticky ends which is able to or ready to match with the another single stranded DNA molecule by the treatment with restriction endonuclease. Now, second important enzyme in recombinant DNA technology is DNA ligase. DNA ligase. It is a DNA joining enzyme. Restriction endonuclease is known as molecular seizure. Molecular seizure. While this DNA ligase, it is known as molecular glue. Molecular glue. It is a DNA joining enzyme. It requires ATP and there is formation of phosphodiesterase linkage. Phosphodiester linkage. There is bond formation. Another enzymes which are used in the recombinant DNA technology, they are polymerase, then alkaline phosphatase, reverse transcriptase, etc. These are the important enzymes which are used in recombinant DNA technology. Now, second important thing in recombinant DNA technology is vector. They are transport vehicles. They are used for the transport of desired piece of gene into a host cell. So there are five main types of vectors. First one is the plasmid, which is a double-stranded extra chromosomal material, and it is important because independent replication occurs in the plasmid. So plasmid is the first. Second, bacteriophage. Third one is the cosmid. Then fourth is the yeast artificial chromosome. Fifth one is the bacterial artificial chromosome. And sixth one is the mammalian artificial chromosome. These are the different vectors which are used as a vector in the recombinant DNA technology. The plasmid, it is able to insert the segment of DNA less than 10 kb with the help of plasmid. With the help of bacteriophage, 10 to 20 kb. Cosmid, it is a combination of bacteriophage and plasmid. It is able to insert a fragment of 35 to 50 kb in length. Then bacterial artificial chromosome, it is able to insert a fragment of less than 300 kb. Yeast artificial chromosome up to 1 MB, mammalian artificial chromosome up to 1 MB. This is the size of insert into a DNA fragment, size of DNA fragment which is inserted into a recombinant DNA. So this is the importance of vector. Examples of plasmids are plasmid discovered in University of California. This is the first. Then plasmid lowercase p. Then Bolivar and Rodrigo Hughes. These are the names of discoverer. And 322, they gave the number 322 to the this plasmid. That's why the name is PBR322. So this is about the vectors. Third important thing is the hosts. Generally, prokaryotic hosts, they are preferred because of rapid multiplication. Most commonly, E. coli and Bacillus subtilis. Then in eukaryote, it is fungi, then mammalian cell, plant cell, mammalian cells, oocytes, they are used. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is used as a host in eukaryote. The advantage in eukaryotic host is there is post-translational modification in eukaryotic host. So this is the third tool. And fourth important tool is gene transfer techniques. Gene transfer techniques. This includes transformation. Transduction, electroporation, then gene gun technique, then particle bombardment. These are the different conjugation. These are the different techniques of introduction of vectors into a host cells. They are known as gene transfer methods. So this is all about the steps involved in the recombinant DNA technology and molecular tools which are utilized in the recombinant DNA technology.